So what's happening this week has been over 2 weeks in the making. It's something we've been watching for quite some time, and there is yet another chance of some wintry weather over mainly North Alabama and Southern Tennessee on Thursday. Otherwise, just a miserable cold rain for Central Alabama. Roads remain icy on Thursday in the same areas that they've been icy so far all week long. We've got a hard freeze through early Thursday morning with temps in the teens and 20s. And then the issue with the cold rain versus the mix of rain and sleet and freezing rain to the north, that is a very interesting test case for us to see just how this is going to respond, because we don't get to see this very often. What you see right here on your screen, this is Court Street, downtown Florence. You can see that's the intersection at Mobile Street. You're looking south away from the University of North Alabama, and that's just a sheet of ice. So what happens when it rains on that tomorrow with the temperature near freezing? Is the raindrop itself warm enough to help melt some of that at maybe 36, 37 degrees? Or is that surface now so cold and the temperature in the air cold enough that the raindrop will cool enough that it adds to the ice? That's a question that we're just going to have to watch play out in real time. And here's what it looks like. This is the latest run of the HRRR model, the HRR, as of Wednesday night at 9:15 p.m. This is 10 o'clock Thursday morning, and here's the issue. You've got 31 in Jasper, 29 in Hamilton, 26 in Florence, 33 Cullman, Huntsville, 32 Scottsboro. In this zone right here, dew point temperatures are in the lower 20s. So any evaporative cooling whatsoever will probably get those numbers back into the upper 20s to near 31, 32 degrees. Again, is it heavy enough? This is very light precipitation as it comes in. So is it heavy enough to really cause any issues? Well, watch it expand eastward. And sure enough, what will happen throughout the day is a southeast wind is pulling some slightly milder air in. We can even feel that up at elevations tonight up in Birmingham on Red Mountain. The wind is already out of the south. It's not quite as cold up here as it is down in most of the valleys as I'm recording this. Well, so what happens in Florence tomorrow afternoon? Do we finally warm up enough that this is just rain, or is it still freezing rain? Same thing in Huntsville. And even there, look, there are going to be parts of Madison County that are different than other parts. And then up into Tennessee, forget it. This is mainly just rain, freezing rain rather, and sleet. Finally, late Thursday night, look at this. We're up to the low 40s in Birmingham, that southeast wind still blowing. It may come above freezing for a couple of hours up here in this hardest hit zone in North Alabama, but it won't be there for long. This is 3 a.m. Friday. We're back down to 31 in Florence, 33 in Cullman and Hamilton, 35 in Jasper, 33 in Huntsville. So the same areas that barely went above freezing drop right back below it early Friday morning. And then looky here. Remember those snow showers we had early Wednesday or early Tuesday? Well, they're coming back, and this could coat the ground again in North Alabama. Remember, everything is frozen in North Alabama and Southern Tennessee too. So just a little bit of snow and a little bit of freezing rain, a little bit of sleet could go a long way to just make conditions worse. And I don't think we're going to see a ton of sunshine on Friday. So look at this, 21 Florence. This is noon Friday, 21 in Florence, 25 Cullman, 32 Birmingham. Anything that doesn't dry up, if we don't, or that doesn't melt away completely and dry up, it's going to be solid ice again. So here's how I think things are going to pan out. Some light freezing rain, minor accumulations here across North Alabama. We might even get some of it into Jackson, DeKalb, and Marshall. This is kind of the iffy zone over here in northeast Alabama, to Scottsboro, Fort Payne, Gunnersville. Just be on the lookout. I don't think it's going to get any worse than it already is, but it may prevent conditions from getting any better. Jefferson County, Tuscaloosa County, south, down through Prattville, Montgomery, no problem here. Just cold rain. Well, it is a problem that it's cold, but it's just rain. So what about travel impacts? We're thinking Marion County, Winston County, Cullman County, Northern Blount, Marshall. Really, the Sand Mountain side of DeKalb County is worse off than the Lookout Mountain side. But even here, there may be some patchy ice through Friday. But Madison County, think Harvest, Monrovia, Bobo, New Market, Hazel Green, Athens up to Thatch and Elkmont, Ardmore, Cherry Grove, Lentzville, the Salem area, and then Lauderdale County. Poor Lauderdale County. This has been rough a rough go of it here. I just don't see any improvement whatsoever in Lauderdale County, but maybe we get a little bit in Franklin and Marion and Winston. Maybe just a little improvement. And then here, I've added this just because I don't typically like covering all the bases. I like to try to tell you what I think, but there's just enough concern that there might be a few patchy areas of ice that develop. So here's the basic thing. If there's water left on the road by Friday afternoon, it's going to freeze. Most streets and roads in the blue zone, they're passable. And then if it looks wet, once temperatures are below freezing, it's probably going to be ice. And the good news is by Saturday, that's going to move out of here. The Arctic air is still here, but the ice threat is over. Look at the wide range of temperatures at 9:18 p.m. on Wednesday, from 17 at Aniana to 27 Birmingham. Elevation matters. Cullman, not as cold at the airport, 25. Arab, not as cold at 22. Pell City in the Valley, 19. Tuscaloosa's at 24. Here's where we think things are going to end up Thursday morning. Upper teens, low 20s. Cold enough. And this, before some rain, it's going to take some powerful warming to get us above freezing in Haleyville and Russellville and Muscle Shoals. We may get there in Vinemont and Huntsville and Albertville and Gunnersville and Scottsboro. It's just one of those, the northeastern part of the state here, this is what we're going to have to watch just really, really closely. 7-day forecast. Here's the payoff. It finally starts warming up. We're going to go from the 30s Friday to the 20s Saturday. Oh, goodness. Low teens and single digits, both Saturday morning and Sunday morning. More pipe freezing kind of weather. Monday and Tuesday, it starts warming up. And then we're back in the 60s. How about that? Good chance of rain, too, because the pattern developing next week is very, very different from what we're dealing with right now. A big ridge develops off the southeastern coast. And in this kind of pattern, instead of seeing cold air rushing in from the north, the upper airflow comes more from the southwest, like what you see right there, and a rainy, warm pattern develops. I think we could see some decent rain. And I'm talking maybe a couple of inches of rain around here starting next Tuesday and Wednesday going through next week.